3-4. Hey, Rusty. Check, check.
Rusty, can you turn Kevin up a little bit?
Check, 1-2-3, testing. I'm on green. 1-2-3-4. This is who we live for. 5-6-7-8. Okay. All right. Blue baby.
Check, check, test, 1, 2, 3, 4. Check, check, test, 1. Test, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Check, check. Hey, Rusty, is that keyboard coming through? I'm in the mandolin mic is the one I'm using, the one Ross uses for the mandolin. Good morning. Are you excited to be in the house of the Lord?
I am.
Amen.
Amen. I'm not so sure. I think we're still a little bit sleepy, maybe. We've been worshiping for almost an hour, so we are excited and wound up tight. So this first song is probably going to get you. Let's stand together as we sing, "This is Amazing Grace."
The King of Glory, the King of
ask the ushers if they would come forward as we continue worshiping and celebrating by giving back to God his tithes and our offering. Father, we just love you. Father, we thank you for being our lion. Father, we thank you for being the lamb, the perfect sacrifice. When we fell short, Father, you didn't. Who has the power?
Who has the power to raise the dead? Who can save us from our sin? He is our hope, our righteousness. Jesus, only Jesus. Who can bury the blind to see? Who holds the keys that set us free? He paid it all to bring us peace. Jesus, holy Jesus.
Holy King Almighty. Last part one more time. Holy King Almighty.
Holy King Almighty, Lord, saints and angels all adore. I join with them and bow before Jesus, only Jesus. I join.
Thank you for loving us, Father. We thank you for being the perfect sacrifice, Father. We thank you for knowing what I need today. Knowing what we all need, Father. Whatever that burden is in our life, that need that we have. Father, no matter what we turn to, Father, we just rebuke it right now. Whatever that temptation is in our life, it puts a veil. Keeps us from seeing your face clearly, hearing your voice clearly. Father, we know that no matter what we turn to, nothing is Jesus. You are what we need. Father, I just pray right now, if there's anyone in this place, they have a desire, they have a yearning, they have They may not even know what's going on. They might not even know what's wrong. They just feel a need that they have tried to fill. Father, I just pray that your spirit would move. Thank you for this time, Father. Thank you for the message that we're about to hear. Father, I just pray that it would move on our hearts and that we would be stirred. We would hear what it is you have for each one of us to hear today. In Jesus' name, we all pray. Amen. Please be seated.
Well, I greet you today in the name of Christ. It is great to see you. I hope that you feel welcome because you do. You are. That there's a purpose to your being here today because there is. And I hope that you feel like that God is already waiting on you, that he has a plan and purpose in your life and what he does. I want to spend some time and look at those two verses of Scripture, but primarily, I want to talk today about this thing about what a friend. We sing a song hymn book, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. How many have sung that song before? Raise your hand. Don't be ashamed if you've ever sung out a hymn book before. It's okay. All right? Okay. What a friend we have in Jesus. But you know, when you look at what Jesus said in the scripture that we read this morning, that's pretty high qualification to be a friend of Christ. If you'll be my friend, if you'll obey me. Serendipity is a pleasant and unexpected surprise. I had a serendipitous moment yesterday evening. I got a telephone call from a young man, about not a young man anymore, he's close to my age now. But at that time, I'd not talked to him in 42 years. 42 years. So I get a message on that. By the way, I'm going to try to call Mark. If you call Mark, leave an answer. We get so many visitors now, but I think it's important to have that. Well, he left this message. I've been said, Liz, I'm calling back. I've not talked to this young man in 42 years. He was my auntie. Questions. so finally Paula said, don't you understand I have the power to release you, to set you free? And then Jesus spoke up, and he said, the only power you have over me is that power that is given to you from above. Because you see, he had long time before this been talking to the disciples, to the apostles, he said, nobody takes my life. I lay my life down. Nobody takes my life. And I don't know exactly what happened now. He said, this is my time. Follow my command. No, there's no greater love than this, but a man that laid in his life for his friends, and he said, this is my friend. And he will obey my command. All obedience to me. Now, what that calls us to do, it occurs to me, is to do the same thing Jesus was going to do, that is to lay down our life. To lay down our life. Paul caught on to that. In fact, the ultimate would cost him his life, wouldn't it? You might remember how Paul was beheaded. Eventually, he was executed for the sake of the gospel of Jesus Christ. But Paul understood that in the book of Romans, when he wrote to the Roman Christians in 12:1, he said, present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. Lay down your life, your body, a living sacrifice. In other words, you've got to die to self. Live for Christ. You've got to give up your right to save mine. Like Jesus did in the Garden of Gethsemane. When he's praying, three times he asked the same thing. I've got to tell you, folks, if it's been me and knowing that Jesus knew what was ahead of him and what was facing him, I've got to tell you, I'd have spent some time that I wouldn't have been thinking. Where we are as a culture, everything is about I. I remember when I went through basic training, I don't know how y'all went through basic training, but when I went through basic training, the first time I said I, a drill instructor came up like that. He said, I'll give you more than I, I'll post you an I. Well, you give up a right to say things like mine, my life, my choice. And then they give you a uniform, and you put that uniform on. But let me tell you something. When we become part of the army of God, you don't dress like you want to anymore. We become a part of the army of God. We're told that we're supposed to take on, we dress ourselves, we're saved, we're clothed in righteousness. Said, Lord Jesus had to pray the way John taught his disciples to pray. He said, well, this is how you do it. Not thy will be done. He prayed, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. He said, mine and the Lord. Jesus said, it's going to be a sign. It's going to be a sign. Give us a life. I'm not what I ought to be yet.
came sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and carried the
Let's stand together as we sing, Run to the Father.
I've carried a burden for too long on my own. I wasn't created to bear it alone. hear your invitation to let it all go. And I see it now, I'm laying it down, and I know that I need you. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, and oh, oh. You saw my condition, had a pen from the start. Your son for redemption, the price for my heart. Oh, I don't have a context for that kind of love. I don't understand, I can't comprehend. All I know is
I'm not afraid.
hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again.
Now to him that is able to keep you from falling and present you without fault for the presence of his glory that is speaking gladly. The only wise God, our Savior, Jesus Christ, glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever.